carbon and compounds. This chapter is divided into four parts. 1. Physical properties, bonding in carbon and occurrence in nature.
2. Hydrocarbons and its types, functional groups and IUPAC naming.
Number 3. Chemical reactions involving carbon compounds, ethanol and ethanoic acid.
4th. Soaps and detergent.
Carbon has atomic number 6 and it has atomic mass 12.
This means that carbon has a configuration of 2,4. Hence, it has 2 electrons in the inner shell and 4 in the outermost.
Therefore, it requires 4 more electrons to complete its octet. Carbon can either lose 4 electrons or gain 4 electrons, but does none of them, as in order to do so, it requires a large amount of energy which is not present. So what does carbon then do?
It shares 4 electrons. 2 or more atoms share electron in order to become stable and forms bond, and such bonds are known as covalent bonds.
Oxygen has 6 electrons in its outermost shell,
whereas hydrogen has only 1. Oxygen requires 2 electrons, so it takes 1 each from the hydrogen. Whereas hydrogen requires 1 more, so it takes 1 from oxygen. And now we have our H2O molecule ready.
Similarly, carbon has 4 electrons in the outermost shell and oxygen has 6.
Carbon requires 4 more electrons, so it shares 2 each from the 2 oxygens, and oxygen 2 shares 2 electrons from the carbon atom. And this time we have our CO2 molecule ready. Similarly, you guys and girls can try CH4, NH3 and C2H6. Allotropes, the property due to which an element exists in nature in 2 or more than 2 forms, is known as allotropy, and its forms are known as allotropes.
Carbon has 3 allotropes, that is graphite, diamond and Buckminster fullerenes. Graphite has good electrical conductivity, it acts as a lubricant and has a layered structure. The pencil we use has its lead made of graphite.
Diamond has complex structure, good optical property. It is the hardest substance on the planet Earth. For example, go and ask your mommy to show you a diamond pendant. The most sparkling part of it is diamond.
Buckminster fullerin is made up of 60 carbons and it has a football-like structure.
Carbon has 2 properties which makes its study interesting: tetravalency and catenation.
As discussed in the previous video, carbon forms 4 bonds, and this property of carbon to form 4 covalent bonds is known as tetravalency. The ability of carbon atom to form long chains through self-linking is known as catenation.
Hydrocarbons. As the name suggests, the compounds formed of hydrogen and carbon are called hydrocarbons.
They are of 2 types, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons.
Saturated hydrocarbon are those which only contains carbon-carbon single bond, and this family of compounds are known as alkanes. Unsaturated hydrocarbon are of 2 types, containing carbon-carbon double bond. This family of carbon are known as alkenes, and carbon-carbon triple bond, and this family of compounds are known as alkynes.
For example, some compounds of alkanes are methane, ethane and propane. Don't worry if you are struggling with the names, you'll sort out them later in the video.
Similarly, some compounds of alkene are ethene, propene, etc. Some compounds of alkynes are ethyne, propyne, etc.
Now let's bring on those names that we used earlier. It's not me or your friend who decides the naming of these compounds. There is an authority which does so, which is the IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry.
This union decides rules and steps of naming these varied compounds of carbon. Let's get to these rules now. Trust me, they are easy.
Name of compounds are based on number of carbon atoms present in them. So let's consider the following number of atoms: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And guess what? You have different prefixes for each. They are myth, it, prop, bute, pent, hex and so on.
We have discussed earlier, there are three families present: alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. They have their own suffix ane, ene and yne.
So if we join them, what do we get? Let's try it out with prop, that is three carbons. It comes out as propane, propene and propyne. Similarly, if you try for others, you will get methane, ethane, ethene, ethyne, butane, butene, butyne, pentane, pentene and pentyne, hexane, hexene and hexyne.
You may wonder why we have left out methane and methyne. Well, those compounds are not chemically possible and hence does not exist. We will discuss about them later in this video.
Now let's draw the structures. Remember, for drawing the structures, you need to recall an important feature of carbon, tetravalency.
That is the ability of carbon to form four covalent bonds. Now let's draw the structure. Methane. If you look at the name, it has a prefix meth. That means one carbon, and ane means carbon-carbon single bond. Since there is only one carbon, there is no need of it right now. Next step is to add four bonds to each carbon present. And the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is since we are studying hydrocarbons. This is our methane ready.
Remember, we discussed earlier that methane and methyne does not exist. Now we will know why. Meth says one and ene says carbon-carbon double bond. Since there is only one carbon, double bond will not happen. Same is in the case of methyne. One carbon and carbon-carbon triple bond, which is not possible.
Ethane. If you look at the name, it has a prefix "eth", E-T-H, which means two carbon, and "ane", which means carbon-carbon single bond. So insert single bonds between each carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon is already done with one bond and three remains, and so does the other carbon too. The final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is our ethane ready.
Propane. If we look at the name, it has a prefix prop. That means three carbon, and ane means carbon-carbon single bond. So insert single bonds between each carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon is already done with one bond. The next carbon has two bonds already and two bonds remain, so we need to add two more bonds. And last carbon has one bond, so we need to add three more. And the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is our propane ready.
Ethene. If we look at the name, it has a prefix "eth", which means two carbon, and "ene" means carbon-carbon double bond. So insert double bond between each carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon has already done with two bonds and two remains, so does the other carbon. And the final step is to add hydrogen to these bonds. This is our ethene ready.
Propene. If you look at the name, it has a prefix prop. That means three carbon and ene means carbon-carbon double bond on any pair. Let's say this pair and insert single bonds between each remaining carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon is already done with two bonds. And we need to add two more, right? The next carbon has three bonds already and one bond remains. And the last carbon has one bond, so we need to add three more. And the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is our propene ready.
Ethyne. If you look at the name, it has a prefix "eth", that means means two carbon and two, and ion means carbon-carbon triple bond. So insert triple bond between each carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon is already done with three bonds and one remains, and so does the other carbon too. And the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is our ethyne.
Propyne. If you look at the name, it has a prefix prop. That means three carbon and ine, which means carbon-carbon triple bond on any pair. Let's say this pair and insert single bonds between each remaining carbon pair. Next step is to add four bonds of each carbon present. So this carbon is already done with one bond, and we need to add three more. The next carbon has four bonds already, and no more bonds remains. And the last carbon has three bonds, so we need to add one more. The final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. This is our propyne. Similarly, you can try the rest, but be careful with higher number of carbons as you need to add one more step. For example, let's take the case of pentene and pentyne. Pentene, if you look at the name, it has a prefix pent, that means 5 carbon, and ene means carbon-carbon double bond on any pair. Let's say this pair and insert single bonds between each remaining carbon pair. Next step is to add 4 bonds of each carbon present. So we do it, and the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. Now, while naming it rather than simply pentene, we have to specify the position of the double bond present in this case. It is 2 from right and 3 from the left. So this is not pentene, rather it is pent to ene. Now let us look at pentyne. If we look at the name, it has a prefix pent, that means 5 carbon and ene, which means carbon-carbon triple bond on any pair. Let's say this pair and insert single bonds between each remaining carbon pair. Next step is to add 4 bonds of each carbon present. So we do it, and the final step is to add hydrogen to each bond. Now, while naming it rather than simply pentene, we will have to specify the position of the double bond present in this case. It is 4 from the right and 1 from the left. So this is not pentyne, rather it is pent-1-ine.
Now you can try the rest. If we look at the formulas, we find a common pattern. Methane CH4, ethane C2H6, propane C3H8, having a common alkane formula of CnH2n+2. Ethene C2H4, propene C3H6, having a common alkene formula CnH2n. Ethyne C2H2, propyne C3H4, having a common alkyne formula CnH2n-2. Isomerism, property due to which different compounds have same formula but different structures, is called isomerism, and the different structures are called isomers. Following are different isomers of butane having formula C4H10. N-butane stands for normal butane, and isobutane, also called one-branch butane. Following are different isomers of pentane having formula C5H12. N-butane stands for normal pentane, isopentane, also called one-branch pentane, and neopentane, also called two-branch pentane.
Rings. Carbon chains are not always straight. They might be rings as well, such as these. We only need to add word cyclo to name them.
Example, cyclopropane, or cyclobutane, or cyclopentane.
Functional groups. An atom or a group of atoms which decides the chemical properties of a carbon compound is called a functional group. There are many, but here we need to learn these 5. Halogens, alcohols, aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids.
if a hydrogen of a carbon compound is replaced with that of chlorine, bromine, fluorine or iodine, then these are called halogen functional groups. Their naming includes addition of prefix chloro, bromo, fluoro or iodo with respect to their positions. For example, consider this following compound. This is pentane with chlorine attached at number 2. So we will write it as pentane first of all and add 2 chloro to its left. So it's 2 chloropentane.
If a hydrogen of a carbon compound is replaced with that of OH group, then those are called alcohol functional group. Their naming include addition of suffix OL with respect to their position. For example, consider the following. This is pentane with OH attached to number 3, so we will write it as pentane first of all and add 3 OL to its right. But remember, two vowels do not come together, so we have to remove E or pentane, so it is pentane 3 OL.
Now, if two terminal hydrogen, that is hydrogen present at the end of a compound, is replaced with that of an oxygen atom, then those are called aldehyde functional groups. Their naming includes addition of suffix al, ol, with respect to their positions. For example, consider this following compound. This is pentane with oxygen attached at number 1. So we will write it as pentane first of all and add 1 ol to its right. But remember, two vowels do not come together, so we have to remove the alphabet E of pentane, and so it is pentane 1 ol.
If two non-terminal hydrogen, that is hydrogen not present at the end of a carbon compound, is replaced with one oxygen atom, then those are called ketone functional group. Their naming include addition of suffix 1 with respect to their position. For example, consider the following compound. This is pentane with oxygen attached at number 2. So we will write it as pentane first of all and add 2 O-N-E to its right. But remember, two vowels do not come together, so we have to remove E of pentane. So it is pentane 2 on.
If three terminal hydrogen, that is hydrogen present at the end of a carbon compound, is replaced with that of one oxygen atom and one of hydroxyl group, then those are called carboxylic acid functional group. Their naming includes addition of suffix oic acid with respect to their position. For example, consider this following compound. This is pentane with O attached at number 1, so we will write it as pentane first of all and add 1 oic acid to its right. But remember, two vowels do not come together, so we have to remove E of the pentane. So it is pentane 1 oic acid.